In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Our brothers and sisters, as we gather for Mass this morning on the feast of St. Bartholomew, who is an apostle and martyr for the faith, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries.
He was sent to heal a contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to gather sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heaven and kingdom, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father.
Amen.
Let us pray. Strengthen in us, O Lord, the faith by which the blessed Apostle Bartholomew clung wholeheartedly to your Son. And grant that through the help of his prayers, your church may become for all the nations the sacrament of salvation. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Rabbi, you are the Son of God, you are the King of Israel.
May the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. Philip found Nathanael and told him, "We have found the one about whom Moses wrote in the law, and also the prophets, Jesus, son of Joseph, from Nazareth." But Nathanael said to him, "Can anyone good come from Nazareth?" Philip said to him, "Come and see." Jesus saw Nathanael coming toward him and said of him, "Here is a true child of Israel. There is no duplicity in him." Nathanael said to him, "How do you know me?" Jesus answered him and said, "Before Philip called you, I saw you under the fig tree." Nathanael answered him, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." Jesus answered and said to him, "Do you believe because I told you that I saw you under the fig tree? You will see greater things than this." And he said to him, "Amen, amen, I say to you, you will see heaven opened and the angels of God ascending and descending on the Son of Man." The Gospel of the Lord.
John's call of disciples is quite different from the calling that we usually hear from the Synoptic Gospels, in which Jesus walks along the Sea of Galilee and calls Simon and Andrew, James and John, who are fishing, and asks them to be fishers of men. St. John the Evangelist introduces St. John the Baptist to us. St. John the Baptist had some followers. He reflected those followers away from him toward Jesus when he said to two of his disciples, "Behold the Lamb of God," one of which was Andrew, brother of Peter. The two heard what John said and started to follow Jesus. It may well be that they were too shy to approach him directly and follow at a distance behind him. Jesus turned and spoke to them. In other words, he met them halfway. He made it easier for them to follow him. Here we have a symbol of the divine initiative. It is always God who makes the first step to us when we reach out to him in prayer. The Catechism of the Catholic Church tells us that when we decide to pray, it is always the Holy Spirit that is there before we make that decision, who is there to motivate us to pray. And that is what we see here in Jesus reaching out to those two disciples following him. The next day, Andrew invited Simon Peter to meet him. Jesus looked at Simon and said, Philip went and found his friend Nathanael and told him, "We have found Jesus, the Messiah, from Nazareth." But Nathanael replied, "Can anything good come from Nazareth?" Philip said to Nathanael, "Come and see." Nathanael was prejudiced against Jesus initially because he came from Nazareth. And he was prejudiced against the Nazareans. But Jesus said to Nathanael, "Before Philip called you, I saw you when you were under the fig tree." Nathanael then responded to Jesus, "You are the Son of God, the King of Israel." In John's Gospel, Nathanael is called, but he is really known as Bartholomew, whose feast we celebrate today. St. Bartholomew is an apostle of Jesus. He is said to have preached the gospel in India and Armenia, where he was martyred. So this morning, let us pray to St. Bartholomew and ask him to intercede with us in finding Jesus in those whom we meet today.
Trusting in our faithful and loving God, who called the apostles and now calls us, we turn to him with these prayers and intentions. We pray for Pope Francis, Bishop Duca, and all of our church leadership, that the Holy Spirit might always guide them in their ministry, in the shepherding of souls. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are within the projected paths of these storms, through the intercession of Our Lady of Prompt Succor, may they be spared from all loss of life and damage and property. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For teachers and students, although everything is put on pause this week because of the storms, for their perseverance and their openness to the Spirit's guidings and promptings as they form and educate young minds, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase in the awareness of one's vocation, whether it be to married life, the diaconate, the priesthood, religious life, for the Holy Spirit's promptings in their lives and their openness to respond to God's call, let us pray to the Lord. We pray for Lynn Miette and Andre Duda, for whom this Mass is being offered, and for all the prayers and petitions which we now hold in the silence of our hearts. Good and gracious God, yours is the call, but ours is the answer. Send us always your Holy Spirit to enlighten us and to strengthen us to be able to say yes to where you call us, as St. Bartholomew did. Hear now and answer these prayers according to your will and according to your time, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we celebrate anew the feast day of Saint Bartholomew, O Lord, we pray that we may obtain your help through the intercession of the Apostle, in whose honor we bring you this sacrifice of praise. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you, Eternal Shepherd, do not desert your flock, but through the blessed apostles, watch over it and protect it always, so that it may be governed by those you have appointed shepherds to lead it in the name of your Son. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy,
holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, holy, God of hosts, heaven and earth, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, power, glory, yours.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other a sign.
Lamb of God, behold, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word.
Those unable to receive Holy Communion, whether here in person or joining us via live stream at home, we offer this act of spiritual communion. Most Holy Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Most Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. May I never be parted from you. Amen. Let us pray. As we celebrate the feast day of the blessed Apostle Bartholomew, we have received the pledge of eternal salvation, O Lord, and we pray that it may be of help to us, both now and for the life to come, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just a word of note, several people have asked, with these storms coming, we will continue to have daily Mass as much as we're able, unless, of course, we lose power. Please do not feel, if you do feel unsafe, driving on the road that you need to come to daily Mass. We will continue to stream on Facebook and our website as much as we can, but just the simple answer is we will continue to have daily Mass as long as we're able to. With that being said, please be safe. Please know of our prayers for you. Please pray for us as well, and we will get through this just as we always have. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Go in peace for the greater glory of God.
Thanks be to God.